In this Photoshop tutorial, I'm going to show you how to blend images together and create a collage like what you see here. So the first step is to bring in the three images that we're going to work with. So we're going to choose File, and then rather than going to Open, go to Scripts. And then under Scripts, what we want to do is we want to load files into a stack. This is going to put them all into one document. So we want to browse to a folder. So we hit Browse. And I've already created a folder. I've called it Travel, and I've dropped these three images in here. So let's select the images and click OK. You'll see them loaded here. And then we're just going to click OK. And Photoshop is going to build a new document and drop the three images one on top of the other. Now I'm just going to hit Control 0, and that'll zoom out so we can see the entire image. Now what we want to do is we want to kind of crop it to the size that we're going to use. So we're going to grab the crop tool. Make sure delete cropped pixels is not checked. If it does that, it's actually going to cut away the other parts of the image. And let's just kind of set a size. If you want to hit a specific size, just type it in here. That's the width, that's the height, and then type in your resolution. I've got another tutorial on resolution, check that out. But for now, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to eyeball it to a shape because the particular size doesn't really matter for what we're doing here. All right, so let's say this is the size and the shape that we want to use. Let's just hit the check mark or click OK. Now, let's have a look at what we want to do. We're going to put these images together. Let's hide the background. And we're going to start with this shot here. All right, let's grab the Move tool. And then we're just going to position this image. So we want our subjects to be about here. This is where we're going to blend it between the two images. Let's take the image of our woman and let's drag it to the top. Great. And what I want to do is I want to make her bigger. So we're going to hit Control T. That's Command T on Mac. Now, quite often as a best practice, you don't want to enlarge images, but for the sake of this tutorial, we're not going to get into all of that because this is going to look fine for the resolution we're working on. So I'm just looking at the kind of size here, and this looks pretty good. I want her quite large. Great. So what we want to do now is blend these two images together. So the first thing we want to do is just create a layer mask on top. So with the top layer selected, choose the new layer mask, and you'll see we get a mask there. Let's hit the D key. That resets the foreground and background colors to black and white. Now what we want to do is grab our gradient tool. With the gradient tool selected, the options will become available. Under the options, let's make sure we use foreground to background or black to white. You'll probably find those under the basics, by the way. And by default, here's just a little tip for you. They'll look like this. They'll be in this folder. If you don't want to have to dig into the folder every time for these important swashes, just click one, hold the shift key, click the last one that selects them all, drag them out to the top, and now they're always going to be visible. That'll just save you a lot of time in the future. All right, so make sure that we're using a linear. We want our mode normal opacity 100. That's great. Now what we're going to do is with our layer mask selected, we're going to click drag. Watch what happens as I click and drag across there. See how we get this nice blend. If you want to blend more, drag it further. So basically, you know, if we go this far, we're going to get a much bigger blend. So the difference between where you start and where you end is where that blend's going to happen. See that? So a smoother blend, you're going to start further away and go further. But one of the things you want to be aware of is not to get the edge of the document. What do I mean by that? If I go here and I hit the shift key, you can see that edge. Make sure those edges don't show because that will make your blend not really look very good. In this case, I don't like where that door is, so let's maybe start here and we can get a smoother blend like that. I think that looks nice. Great. Now let's go on and apply an overlay. So to create an overlay, we use something like a texture or a pattern, and we're going to grab this vintage map, and I'm going to turn this on. By the way, all these images I grabbed from Envato Elements. I'll give you guys a link underneath for that. All right, so here's the vintage, and I'm going to make it a little bigger. So Control T, that would be Command T on map, will bring up our free transform, and then we just drag a corner and we can make this larger or smaller. Now, if the shape is changing when you're dragging it, hold down the shift key and that will constrain it. All right, so what we're gonna do is change the blending mode. There's basically three options. We can go into the darken modes here. And notice as we go into these darkens, it'll create a very kind of a, it'll darken the image and create a kind of a grungy effect. It's kind of an interesting effect. Or we can go into the lighten and this will make it brighter and see how that interacts. It hides black. Or we could go into the overlay modes and get a different type of blending. So it really depends on the look you're going for. So different images, you're going to want to try different types of blending modes depending on what kind of images you're working with. I'm going to use overlay in this case for now. And then we're going to take the opacity and drop this back a little bit because we want this to kind of blend into the image. There we go. See how things are starting to blend in a little bit better now. Now, of course, right now it's over our model, it's over our faces. We don't want to do that. So what we're going to do is we're going to just hide it in certain areas. So let's create a new layer mask. Layer mask selected. Make sure we've got black for our foreground color. So if you just hit the X key, that'll make black. And what we're going to do is we're going to hide it in certain areas. So we're going to grab a brush. And what you want to do is just grab a soft round brush. Now, if you've got pen pressure, that's really great too. If you're working with something like a Wacom, that'll work well. I'm just going to keep the opacity up really high at 100 in this case, and I'm just going to paint over the areas I don't want it to be. Like, I don't want it over the top of our model here. We don't really want it over their faces, so let's just kind of drag there. Now, if you want to kind of make it a little less in certain areas, now we can drop our flow or opacity down. Let's drop our opacity down quite low to around about 18. And now I can start to just fade it from certain areas where I feel, you know, hey, it's a little strong here. Just soften it down in these certain areas and go over it more than once to increase that effect and see what we can do. We can start to just kind of control how this is going to be. So we're getting rid of it, but not completely. It's just kind of fading it a little bit. So it's adjusting opacity selectively. All right, let's add a nice color effect over the top, but rather than using a LUT, we're actually going to use a gradient to colorize it. But before we use the gradient, what we want to do is choose our colors. I'm going to choose a warm and a cool color. So first thing you want to do is make sure you're not on the mask, make sure you're on the layer. And now we're going to grab our color picker and we can see we can choose colors like this, or we can move out the color picker and actually choose colors from the image just by dragging around. Now, had we been on the mask, you wouldn't see these colors. You would just see the black and white from the mask, which is why we chose the colors there. So we can see there's a lot of interesting colors we could pick up from this image. I think I'm going to grab that warm color here from the guitar. And we're going to click OK. Now we also want to choose a color for the background. So let's click the background swatch and do the same thing. Let's grab some of the blue here, maybe from there. Let's just kind of play around and just find a little less saturated version of that color. So as we go across to the left, it reduces the saturation. There's our foreground background. Great. Let's apply this now as a color. So we're going to grab our adjustment layer and choose a gradient. Now, make sure under the gradient type, we're going to change this to foreground background. And we can see there's our colors that we set for the foreground background. That's excellent. Now, we want to change the angle. So let's just drag the angle out. Actually, go the other way. There we go. So we've got blue on one side. We've got our orange on the other side. Now, if you change the scale, this will make it more abrupt or it will make it more gradual. So it's kind of up to you how you want to work with that. The nice thing is because we're using these adjustment layers, we can change it later. Okay, so what we want to do is change the blending mode now from normal to color. So when we go down to color, notice what it does is it applies the color from our gradient onto the image and allows all the image detail to show through. The next step we want to do though is let some of the original colors blend through. So let's take the opacity, drop that down a little bit, and notice we can see those original colors now. We're just at about a 20%. And what we're doing is we're just influencing the original hues. If we go before, you can see, and after. So just dial that in until you find the amount of color that you want to influence. I think that's looking pretty good. All right, next thing we want to do is drop some type in here, and we're going to do a neat effect with the type. So what we're going to do is grab the type tool, and the font I'm using here is Nexa Rust Sans, and I'm just going to type, and we're going to do adventure. Of course, you can choose any font you like. I want to change the color of this font, so let me just select it, and we're going to change the color to white. And let's make it larger. So what you want to do is just grab, see where it says type? Just drag it, and we can make our type larger. Grab the move tool, and we'll drag it over. Great. Okay, let's apply a neat effect to this. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to add a drop shadow, but we don't want to show anything. We're going to make it empty and just let the drop shadow show by itself. So to do that, we're going to go under effects, and these are our layer styles. Let's choose our drop shadow. And the important thing for the drop shadow is opacity all the way up, distance to zero, because otherwise see how it's going to show at an angle. And then just play around with the size, so we just kind of get the shadow around the edges. The size is actually the softness. And if you want to see what the final result's going to look like, go under blending options, and you'll see opacity and fill opacity, same as we have on the layers panel. And what we're going to do is take the fill opacity all the way down. See what that does is it hides the textures, but it allows the effect to show through. So let's go to our drop shadow. You can see there. So just the drop shadow is showing by itself. I'm going to click OK. Now I feel like, okay, we got a little carried away. I want to show a little bit more in there. So notice the fill opacity is at zero. So this is also available in the layers panel. So let's just turn that up just a little bit. Great. Let's duplicate that. Control J. And now we're going to take the opacity all the way up and the fill opacity all the way up. All right, so I want to blend this with the more transparent one underneath to create a kind of a gradient effect. So once again, let's create a layer mask. We're going to go back to our gradient tool again. Make sure you hit the D key, reset foreground background colors to black and white. And once again, we're using our linear gradient, just like we did before. And we can see how this is going to look. So if we drag from the top down, we can see it looks that way. If we go the other way, it goes like that. I'm going to let it fade a little bit at the top and fade down to more opaque at the bottom because I just feel like it blends better with our collage. Now, we can take our opacity and then we can just dial in how much we want to show underneath. If you like this kind of feel, that's great. If you feel like, man, it just feels a little dark, I want it a little brighter, well, then we can choose our overlay. See, that's our overlay layer, and change it to something like screen mode. And notice as we go into screen mode, we can get a completely different feel. So that was a fun creative project this week. Let me know in the comments if you learned anything new and there's any areas you'd like me to expand on in future tutorials. And by the way, if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. If you've been here for a while and you haven't yet subscribed, have a look there and hit that subscribe button if you haven't, because I don't want you to miss the tutorials either. And do me a favor, hit that like button. It helps with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.